There's a new name for Seattle's Capitol Hill neighborhood, a six-block area occupied for over a week now by demonstrators after police boarded up and left the East Precinct following tensions and violent clashes between protesters and police. Demonstrators are calling for an end to police brutality in the wake of George Floyd's killing.
It's not nothing aggressive or violent or nothing like that. That's what those faces on the walls, black lives killed by the police. We want people to see that those lives matter.
Demanding to defund the police, invest in the community, and release arrested protesters. The encampment has turned into a festival city of its own, with tents, gardens, and music. Some say the movement has lost focus.
This is not Coachella. We're not hosting a free block party, and this is a political movement.
And want to bring back the attention to why this all started.
And this is our moment right now, so we don't want you to come out here and try to put your agenda in place for your movement. This is the Black Lives Matter movement for blacks to stop being killed and for us to get our fair shake in America that we haven't gotten so far.
For the most part, the zone remains peaceful, but the scenes are enough to anger President Trump.
The governor has to call out the troops, do what he has to do, has to call out the National Guard. Has to do something.
One of the things this president will never understand is that listening to community is not a weakness. It is a strength.
But concerns from neighbors are growing.
Many businesses are afraid to open.
And there are worries over access for emergency crews, which is why these were brought in to create some space, something protesters say they worked with the city to do.
This change is going to open traffic back up to over 1,000 residents on 12th Street.
A signal they say that they're willing to work with authorities. Tina Lovegreen, CBC News, Vancouver.